side of the screen, and anchors will be asking me. So it's actually a dream for a TV reporter to be grilling anchors. Well, I'm no longer in TV, but I'm now for a newspaper. Thank you very much. Actually, none of them need interaction, but you know, for formality, this is Palki, associate editor, WION, Sachdeva, a familiar face with Republic TV, Rohit, Sardana, quite a rock star on our side. Singhvi, Rishabh, Gulati, Anil, Singhvi is from Z, Rishabh, Gulati is from NEWSNEXT, and Preeti, Dahiya, of course, again, a familiar face with fans now. Thank you very much. As I said, it's a dream panel for me because I get to grill you guys, and it used to be the other way around when I was on TV. But, you know, on a serious note, as you all know, the topic is, are anchors becoming spokespersons? The organizers left the question somewhat vague, spokespersons for whom? For the government or for the opposition? And depending on which channel you watch, you get to decide. So in any case, what we'll do is we will ask each one of you, we have I think about half an hour, we will ask each one of you to share your thoughts on this topic, and then we will have a conversation. Why don't you begin?
Say what I want to say respect to what you're asking. I'm wondering what I'm doing on this panel because if we are talking about spokespersons for a particular political party, I'm not in that space and happily so anymore. Mine is a channel that focuses on international news, but when you say spokesperson, you are presenting an idea. And anybody who believes that journalists are people who only stick to information, who are not opinionated, either deluding himself or herself or lying. Because we express an opinion like all individuals do. And that opinion may or may not match a political ideology. If I speak specifically about WION, we say that we present India's perspective to the world. So are we spokespersons for India? Maybe they are. Maybe we present a point of view of the country, of the government, but we also question. So there's a difference between being opinionated and being biased. I think in today's TV space especially, people come to you as much for information, which is available everywhere else, including social media, as for validation of their opinion. I stand for something, I believe in something, and I do not shy away from expressing it. Matches some ideology or some political views, so be it. To that extent, I think anchors are spokespersons. But they're also spokespersons for their own editorial position and their own individual view. So I don't think there's anything wrong.
Absolutely. Wonderful. What's your take on this?
Hi, because you know, you've just left the entire question very open-ended. So, personally, being in this industry for 16 years now, I've moved from ENZ to NDTV to Times Now to Public. And if you think that that is how I should answer the question, I think news is also a word like that. The news space today is dramatically different. Your viewers are smart, they are intelligent, they have tons of ways which they can gather news from. Whether it's your social media, whether it's your digital space, it's your traditional newspapers, it's your long format, you know, magazines, newsletters, television. So you have to give them a reason why they come to television. When they come to television, they spend some time with you. There has to be engagement. How do you engage? Unless you connect, I think, to your audience, you can't have engagement. And why I also say this is because I've been a reporter, I've been an anchor. So you understand. You understand the difference, you understand the journey. And we at Republic very, very strongly believe in putting out our opinions. I think it's extremely important to take sides. Unless you take a side, what is the point of you doing news? If you just tell me this is so and so, this is so and so, this is something you get almost everywhere. My idea is to speak about a story today that matters to the viewer. for the last few hours, if there is one story, I think that has consumed all of us as a nation, is what happened to Obama. Now, people can have different opinions, you know, but I again strongly believe that if this is not what gets you together as a nation, nothing else. Talk about anything. You can say these are diversionary tactics. The opposition on the first day decided to question the Prime Minister. They realized they should not be doing it very well. The next day you hear a very sensible remark that comes into the Congress President, Rahul Gandhi. And I think that is about the mood of the nation. So I think when we say our anchors or spokespersons, yes, they should always be. Because unless there is a face to a story, there is a voice to a story, people will not come together.
That's right. And I said, actually, the question was left open-ended, and rightly said, the organizers said spokespersons for whom. But the question necessarily that arises, that should the judges be spokespersons for the green side or the government, or should they also articulate the other part of the room? What's your view?
Would you want to tell
me? Please, please.
मुझे लगता है एंकर स्पोक्सपर्सन होता है उस आदमी की भावना जो उसको टीवी पर देख रहे हर समय एंकर ज्ञानी ज्ञान देने वाला सामने वाले को यही साबित कर रहा हो कि देखो तुम लोग मैं ज्ञान दे रहा हूँ उसको ले लो उसको सीख लो तो वो कनेक्ट मिस कर जाता है आज की तारीख में वो चीज़ नहीं चलती है आज की तारीख में मन की बात भी आदमी कभी सुनता है बहुत देर तक जब आप उसके मन की बात करो केवल अपने मन की बात करते हैं तो बहुत देर तक आपसे कनेक्ट नहीं करेंगे जहाँ दीपी ने छोड़ा वहाँ से आगे चीज को कहा इस समय मूड ऑफ द नेशन क्या है आप दो दिन से देख रहे हैं यूनाइटेड कलर्स ऑफ इंडिया में देखा कहीं पे गम है कहीं पे गुस्सा है कहीं पे नाराजगी है कहीं पे प्रोटेस्ट कर रहे हैं तो वो सारी चीज़ें जब हम दिखा रहे हैं अगर वो हम उसके साथ कनेक्ट करते हुए नहीं दिखेंगे तो सामने वाले को लगेगा कि ये क्या चाहता है या मैं कन्फ्यूज करना चाहता है या खुद कन्फ्यूज है और उसमें कोई मेरे से आगे कहेंगे साहब तुम तो वार मॉन्गरिंग थे फिर जिसने अपने घर का बच्चा खो दिया है जिसकी सगाई हुई थी उसकी डेड बॉडी इस बात से पहचानी गई कि उसकी एक बीवी और अंगूठी थी बाकी बॉडी नहीं मिली उसकी उसकी जो होने वाली बीवी थी उसका जो फादर है उसकी जो माँ है वो कह रहे हैं कि हमें अपने बच्चे की लाश नहीं चाहिए हमें अपने बच्चे का बदला चाहिए क्या मैं वो सेंटीमेंट अगर कंट्री को दिखा रहा हूँ या बता रहा हूँ तो क्या मैं किसी पॉलिटिकल पार्टी में स्पोक्स पर्सन हूँ नहीं मैं उस परिवार का उस हर आदमी का स्पोक्स पर्सन हूँ जो कि उसके साथ उस सेंटिमेंट को महसूस कर रहा है उसको फील कर रहा है और सबसे बड़ी बात टीवी पे आती क्यों आ रहा है भाई आपने दो लोगों को कमरे में बंद करके छोड़ दिया और ये कहा कि दोनों लड़ रहे हैं एक कह रहा बाहर बारिश हो रही है दूसरा कह रहा नहीं बात होती थी अब वो मेरे पास आ रहा है टीवी खोल कर तो मेरा काम तो ये ना लड़की मैं उनको बता दूँ कि बाहर बारिश हो रही है कि धूप है या मैं उनको कहूँ कि मैं दोनों फैक्ट्स आपकी तरफ रख रहा हूँ ये कह रहा है कि धूप है ये कह रहा है कि बारिश है आप लोग खुद तय कर लीजिए तो वो कहेगा भाई हमने टीवी क्यों बोला था इसीलिए तो बोला था कि तुमसे सच पता लग जाए सो अभी तक हम लोग क्या करते आए हैं निष्पक्षता के नाम पे हम लोग तटस्थता की पैरवी करते आए निष्पक्षता और तटस्थता दो अलग अलग चीजें हैं जैसा अभी पलकी ने कहा बींग ओपिनियटेड एंड बींग बायस्ड आर टू डिफरेंट थिंग्स तो निष्पक्ष होना और तटस्थ होना भी दो अलग अलग ऐसी चीजें हैं तटस्थ होने का मतलब तो ये होता है कि मैं अंधा बहरा लग रहा हूँ मुझे कुछ नहीं समझ में आता मैं जाऊँ जो कुछ सामने से मिला मैं उठा के लाऊं टीवी के थ्रू अपने दर्शक के फेंक दूं कि भाई तुम खुद तय कर लो क्या ठीक है क्या गलत निष्पक्ष होने का मतलब है कि मैं क्योंकि मैं आप मुझे अपने से बेहतर मानते हैं इसलिए मुझे देखने आते हैं और मैं आपसे ज्यादा रिसोर्सफुल हूँ तो मैं उन सब जगहों पर जा सकता हूँ जहाँ आप नहीं जा सकते आप टीवी पर देखते हैं तो मैं वहां से सारी चीजें देखूं समझूं महसूस करूं और उसके बाद आके आपको बताऊं कि मुझे क्या ठीक है वो है निष्पक्षता तो अगर उस सेंटिमेंट को आवाज देना उस भावना को जनता तक पहुंचाना और निष्पक्षता को सही तरीके से सामने रख देना स्पोक्सपर्सन होना तो आई डोंट माइंड बीइंग अ स्पोक्सपर्सन ऑफ द पीपल ऑफ द कंट्री जो कि मुझे देखते हैं टीवी पे मेरे पर भरोसा करते हैं और केवल आते ही इसलिए देखते हैं कि भाई हम इनका व्यू पॉइंट या इनकी रिपोर्ट में देख लें ये क्या है
इंटरेस्टिंग है कि हमारे तीनों पैनलिस्ट ये मान के चल रहे हैं कि अगर हम हमारी ओपिनियन दे रहे हैं तो हम स्पोक्स पर्सन नहीं है लेकिन आमतौर पर ये दिक्कत तब आती है जब आप पोलिटिकल डिबेट कर रहे हैं न्यूज और व्यूज दोनों में बड़ी एक थिन लाइन है जब आप न्यूज प्रेजेंट कर रहे हैं क्या तब वाकई में आप कोई ओपिनियन दे रहे हैं, लेकिन जब आप यूज प्रेजेंट कर रहे हैं तब क्या कोई ओपिनियन दे रहे हैं। यूज प्रेजेंट करते आप ओपिनियन देने में कहीं कोई बुराई नहीं है। जब आप सिर्फ न्यूज दे रहे हैं तब न्यूज दे रहे हैं। दिक्कत कहाँ है? दिक्कत ये कि जब आप डिबेट करते हैं, किसी से कोई सवाल करते हैं, और जाहिर सी बात है कि अगर मैं ऐसा एंगल हूँ जो किसी सब्जेक्ट मैटर को विषय को पढ़कर जा रहा हूँ, मैं तीखे सवाल पूछूंगा। आज ये फैशन हो गया है कि मीडिया में हंगर्स का स्पोक्स पर्सन बोलते हैं, और फैशन सब तरह की पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज की तरफ से। अगर आपसे तीखा सवाल पूछा गया तो आप कहेंगे कि आप उस पार्टी के एंकर या स्पोक्स पर्सन हैं, और ये समस्या सबके साथ है, हर एक चैनल के साथ हो सकती है, हर एक एंकर के साथ हो सकती है। इसलिए एंकर कई लोग ऐसे हैं जो दबंग होंगे तो बिल्कुल पूछेंगे, कड़क सवाल पूछेंगे, जवाब देने में मुश्किल आएगी, और कुछ एंकर ऐसे होंगे जो अपने करियर की स्टार्टिंग में होंगे या थोड़ा इस तरह का स्टैंड नहीं ले पाते, उन्होंने आज से सवाल पूछना बंद कर दिया, वो एक क्वेश्चन छोड़ देते हैं, क्वेश्चन पूछते ही नहीं, एक स्टेटमेंट देकर छोड़ देते हैं। खुला सवाल है, आपको जो बोलना है बोल दीजिए, बोल कर निकल जाइए। क्यों? अगर मैं एंकर हूँ तो मैं पूछूंगा और डंके की चोट पर पूछूंगा, आपसे खुलकर पूछूंगा। अगर आपको लगता है मैं स्पोक्स पर्सन हूँ तो आप उसका जवाब दीजिए, अच्छे से दीजिए, लेकिन प्रॉब्लम दूसरी है। प्रॉब्लम सिर्फ इस तरफ नहीं है कि एंकर क्या पूछ रहे हैं, प्रॉब्लम दूसरी तरफ की है। जब आपके सामने पैनलिस्ट बैठे होते हैं तो उन्हें मन में क्या कहना है, उन्हें बजाय जो एंकर सवाल पूछ रहा है उसका जवाब देने के, या फिर अपने सामने वाले पॉलिटिकल पार्टी के जो लोग हैं या उनकी जो पॉलिसी है ऊपर जवाब देने के, वो एंकर पर अटैक करेंगे। वे कहेंगे कि आप ये सवाल पूछे इसका मतलब आप स्पोक्स पर्सन है। जी नहीं, आपको झगड़ा करना है, आपको लड़ना है, आपको डिबेट करनी है, आपको सामने वाली पॉलिटिकल पार्टी से करनी है, एंकर से नहीं करनी। लेकिन ना माहौल ऐसा है कि इस तरह की लेबलिंग हो जाती है, और फिर जब लेबलिंग हो जाती है और अगर एंकर पर आप अटैक करेंगे तो एंकर अपने आप को और डिफेंड करने की कोशिश करेगा, अपने स्टैंड को और स्ट्रॉन्ग करने की कोशिश करेगा, और फिर ये डिबेट में इस तरह का पॉइंट निकल कर आता है कि क्या एंकर स्पोक्स पर्सन है। मेरा मानना है बिल्कुल नहीं। जी नहीं, जब हम सवाल पूछते हैं बिल्कुल अच्छे तरीके से, और हर पॉलिटिकल पार्टी के पैनलिस्ट में वही उसी तरह के कड़क सवाल पूछे जाते हैं, लेकिन किसी को झूठ करता है, किसी को नहीं करता है, और फिर क्या
what is your view on this? No, it becomes valuable. Well, he's absolutely right. No one asks a question. It's not arguing anything. Right? That also often happens by the same question. And that's also the beauty, because we're doing across dozens of channels, five, six, seven, today, it's a constant debate. Normally, quite frankly, even if you a political party evidence that you see hanging on. But one thing that's my little bit on this is, people who come to watch you are not coming for interviews anyway, except in very rare circumstances, like the circumstance that happened yesterday. The information is breaking even for us online, right? Our first port of call becomes that. By the time the reporter gets to the spot, is half an hour, 45 minutes, even on a big event that took place yesterday, which is all done things for all of us, is reaction to what we do, which is present what's happening on the spot. The people who come to you have a confirmation bias. Now, not understanding human psychology, the people who come to you are not coming to you as a blank slate, they are coming to you with opinions. They are likely to relate to a person who is not going to be sitting there doing exactly what these people are saying, just be a disinterested party. And sometimes it's very tempting as an example to be a disinterested party, to leave a floater out there and then let them fight it out, to actually control the conversation, to have some cogency in the conversation, make it through. The conversation gets hijacked. And the second bit of my view is, when we are looking at a presentation of our own opinion, is that going to have a basis of a change of bias into nationality? No. Okay? We are opinion, not because we become opinion makers. That doesn't mean we can't have an opinion. And to sit there and not have an opinion makes you a piece of furniture. You're not part of that conversation. You have to be part of the conversation, even if it is to educate that conversation or temper that conversation, as and when was required. Sometimes conversations need to be headed into a particular direction because they're going all over the place. Sometimes they need to be tempered. And for this, the realization for all of us that we don't want to end up speaking to an empty room, because we will soon be hijacked by the sheer flood of information that is out there, and all of us are soon to become irrelevant, and that's a disservice to the people of the country also, because we lose the face value. Today, if I'm saying something, like it, don't like it, I'm accountable for what I said, and that is subject to the laws of diminishing returns and flying. If I'm talking nonsense every day, I will be called out eventually on it. But when it's out there floating in the medium, which does not have a human connect, it can't put a name and a face to it, who knows where it came from, there is no accountability whatsoever. I think all of us should hold accountable today. But he said that was wrong, or he said that was biased, so be it. So these are my two bits on it, it's a realization.
Partly for itself, partly now, so we can even talk about it more later. But Preeti, two questions I think you want to ask you. Our anchor soft targets now, really, I mean, you know, from COVID, everyone has said, you know, it's also important, we are also citizens, and you know, it's also important to articulate what we feel and how strongly we feel about an issue. But there is also this new traditionally, you know, old school journalism, I'm one of them, who draws the line and says, you know, don't be the news, just let the newsmaker be, you know, be the news. So, what do you have to say about this?
So, if I take your first question, are anchors soft targets? Of course they are. And being the faces of a channel, we're carrying too many burdens with us. You know, when you talk about anchors being spokesperson, again, we are carrying too many burdens in the sense that we are also being watched by someone who's a pro BJP, someone who's a pro Congress, someone who hates a particular community, and someone who's secular to the core. Someone likes the idea of India so much so that that nationalistic sentiment is very high on their head. Somebody says, calm down, we can take it easy. So we are actually, when we're sitting on there, we are pretending we're representing everyone, we are being watched by everyone. So for someone, I'm definitely going to be the spokesperson of the other, right? Because there has to be one side of the story that will be highlighted, and it has to stand up. Now, having said that, I also feel that the topic today, our anchors becoming the new spokesperson, is very much perception-based. People have come to associate a certain perception with a certain brand, and they want to just believe in it. Like, all five fingers of our hand are not equal. Everyone under a certain umbrella is not following a certain quote-unquote written script. When we are doing a live debate, we are not following any script. We have to follow what flows through that particular debate. Now, again, because it's not specific to what spokesperson, I'm assuming that primarily it is because of the political debates that we conduct, and my channel has been, you know, branded in a certain way. So I think it's about time that I put out certain facts about it as well. As news anchors, we are also debate moderators. So I think you would understand that, right? We are debate moderators. Now, sometimes we have to take that step further. And we have to indulge in what I call as rescue acts. I'll give you three examples where rescue acts come into play. First is, in a debate, one spokesperson is making personal attacks on the other spokesperson. Or indulging in what about you, which is very common. Now, when you are making personal attacks to the other person, even if I'm not in that party, I will definitely come to his rescue and tell you to calm down. You know, personal attacks are not part of my debate topic, please stay away from it. At that time, the other person will say, oh, wow, you're this spokesperson, I'm taking over. That's one example. Second example is, in a debate, again, there could be a genuinely soft-speaking spokesperson of a political party and a genuinely loud one. Now, if the soft-spoken person is getting hammered left and right and not getting his, you know, 30-second in terms of his response, it is my job as a debate moderator to please button, like they say in media terms, and then, you know, just calm the temperatures down and bring the debate back to where it all started. The third is, and this is extremely important, and this is where we get labeled as spokespersons on a certain side. This is when one spokesperson is underprepared or not prepared, and the other one is putting out wrong facts or tweaking facts as per their convenience for the viewer. I am also responsible for the viewer's consumption, right? What they are getting out of this debate. Now, if this spokesperson is not fully prepared and my research team has backed me up with better facts, I'm definitely going to, you know, pitch in with my facts. Now, you may say, oh, he ke paas zyada jankari hai, zyada spokesperson ki tarah baat kar rahi hai. So, mere ab kal ko jo debate dekh raha hai, wo ye bolega spokesperson ko kuch pata nahi tha, anchor bhi useless thi. That label will also come to us, right? So, you know, we have to carry all of these things in one go during that debate time that we get. And I think it's not fair to label anchors as spokesperson. At the end of the day, just judge one anchor as an individual, not under the brand that they are working for, and secondly, just go with the show, how they all came about.
You know, I actually want to pick up from the last two points that you and Rishabh made. One is that the fact that people are accountable. Viewers come to you because you are Deepti Sachdeva, you are Rohit Sardana, you are Rishabh, you are Preeti, Dahiya, and they would, what you say is important to them, they would believe you. So that also raises the question, should you then have a strong view that may not be to the liking of the other side or the other side of the debate, or should you articulate both the views equally? Rohit, aapka kya kehna hai? जो लोग आपको सुनने आएंगे राहुल आपकी शायरी पसंद करेंगे, आप उनके ओपिनियंस को भी रिस्पेक्ट करेंगे, क्योंकि आप रोहित सरदाना हैं और आप एक एंकर हैं, आपका एक स्टेटस है, आपको लगता है कि आपको जैसे एज वी से इन पॉलिटिक्स एन एम पी फॉर एग्जाम्पल ही नॉट ओनली रिप्रेजेंट्स द पीपल हु वोटेड फॉर देम बट आल्सो द पीपल हु डिड नॉट वोट फॉर देम, राइट? सो डू यू आल्सो आर्टिकुलेट द व्यूज हुज व्यूज मे बी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम योर्स, राइट?
उससे ज़्यादा नहीं, रेयर ही ऐसा इंस्टांस होता है जिसमें मुझे तीन घंटा चार घंटा बैठना पड़ता है। वो एक घंटा उस दिन के विषय के हिसाब से, उस दिन के उस विषय की प्लस माइनस के हिसाब से तय होता है। अब वो सामने वाले को भी पता होता है उस दिन किसके साथ में क्या करना है, तो जिसको पता होता है कि आज उसकी बैठ बनने वाली है, वो पहले से तय करके आता है कि ठीक है ज़्यादा बैठे तो कह देंगे ना कि उसके सोच पसंद की तरह बोल रहे हैं, उससे ज़्यादा करके उसके पास स्पेस पता नहीं करता, तो वो उसको बेस्ट ऑप्शन ये लगता है कि उनको ये बोलो कि आपको दूसरी पार्टी की तरह बोलते। अब एक दिन कांग्रेस वाले कह देंगे कि यार आप बीजेपी के सोच पसंद हो, दो दिन बाद बीजेपी का कोई मंत्री आ जाता है, वो कहता है आपका कांग्रेस का प्रवक्ता की तरह बात करते, तो हमें लगता है ठीक है भाई बढ़िया। अब दर्शक इस चीज को समझता है, उसी से एग्जांपल दे देता हूँ ना, एन राम को लेके चार दिन से पांच दिन से जब वो चिट्ठी छपी है, क्या कुछ नहीं चला है सोशल मीडिया पे, लेकिन उन्हीं एन राम की पिछली स्टोरीज को लेके वही बीजेपी के नेता कितने टाइम से करते रहे होंगे, तो क्या होता है कि एक आदमी की छवि हर राजनेता जो सामने बैठा हुआ है अपने हिसाब से गढ़ने या बिगाड़ने की कोशिश करता है, जैसा उसको सूट करता है, जैसे उन्होंने भी कहा था सूटेबिलिटी के हिसाब से वो पिकेट चूज करते हैं, और उस हिसाब से उनको लगता है कि अच्छा ठीक है आज अगर हमें नुकसान करना तो हम भी डेंट करके बैठ पाते हैं, बट जो दर्शक से घर बैठ के देख रहा है वो सारी चीजें जानता है, क्योंकि आप हफ्ते में दो दिन ड्यूटी पाते हो कि आप किस शो में जाते हैं, वो बाय चॉइस हर रोज उस शो को देखने आता है, उसको पता होता है किस दिन संबित पात्रा जी के साथ ये बैठ गए थे, किस दिन राजीव त्यागी के साथ बैठ गए थे, या घनश्याम जी बैठे सामने, तो किस दिन घनश्याम जी के साथ बैठ गए थे, रोज घनश्याम जी के साथ ही लड़ने बैठ जाते हैं झंडा के, रोज संबित के साथ ही बैठ जाते हैं, रोज राजीव के साथ ही लड़ते हैं, वो सबको पता होता है कि आज ऐसा इशू है कश्मीर की सरकार का, लेकिन जब मसला चल रहा था तो कांग्रेस के स्पोक्सपर्सन से था, तो आज की तारीख में
जो स्पोक्सपर्सन का भी डेफिनेशन बदल जाता है रिटायर होने पर के सी
की समथिंग टू यू रेज दैट पॉइंट, आई थिंक वी आर लिमिटेड द कन्वर्सेशन टू पॉलिटिक्स, इट्स नॉट जस्ट अबाउट द बीजेपी एंड कांग्रेस, दिस इज नॉट व्हाट द कंट्री इज अबाउट, द कंट्री इज अबाउट अस, इट्स अबाउट द पीपल, दिस इज व्हाई आई टेल यू, यू नो वी एज अ पब्लिक आर वेरी क्लियर, वी विल पिक अप पीपल्स इश्यूज, इट कुड बी अ बीबीआई रेसिज्म कैंपेन, इट कुड बी आवर फोर्सेस, बट वी विल डू स्टोरीज इन मैटर टू, so I think it's by default that the entire conversation becomes about Congress versus the BJP or any other political party, and I think that is why the problem just enlarges.
Maybe this comes from perception,
but I think as anchors we are smart enough, we should be able to see this through what is coming and not fall in that trap. I think that is also a challenge, because it's very easy, it's a very easy alibi that we see for most political parties, you know, Congress does not come to a channel at all. So, but you'll get political analyst Sharma sitting there and smiling. I don't know why you still don't come. But you know what, Sharma, it's a participative democracy.
Right.
You know, I just want to make a brief point. It's a participative democracy. The moment you decide not to come to a fora or not to, you know, even speak, and then say, okay, you know, iska chata hai, that is your bias.
अगर किसी पॉलिटिकल पार्टी को ये लगता है कि इस चैनल पर मैं जाता हूँ और ये मेरी एंटी पार्टी वाला चैनल है, आप अपने सबसे बेहतरीन प्लेयर को बताइए वो तो फैक्ट्स फिगर और पूरी तैयारी के साथ काम पहुँचे। आप अगर अपना हाफ प्रिपेयर्ड स्पोक्स पर्सन भेजेंगे और जैसा आपने बताया कि उसकी धुलाई हो रही है तो आपको लगता है कि एंकर समर्थक किससे सही कर रहे हैं, ये गलत है। ये सारे स्पोक्स पर्सन है गेस्ट रूम में एक साथ मिलेंगे, चाय पिएंगे, गपशप मारेंगे, कब शाम को क्लब में मिल रहे हो और बाद में करेंगे आज मैंने इस एंकर को धोया, आज मैंने इस एंकर को धोया। तो एंकर तो है ना, उधर उसके एंकर के बॉस भी है और इधर सामने स्पोक्स पर्सन भी है, दोनों को झेलना है। तो मेरा पॉइंट सिंपल है, जिस चैनल से आपको प्रॉब्लम है, आपको लगता है कि चैनल हमारा एंटी है, आप अपना सबसे बढ़िया फेस भेजिए ऑप्शन लेने की। सिंपल
बेस्ट की फॉर द कॉन्फ्रेंस दिस एब्सोल्यूट पंकी आज इस पर कंप्लीट यू सेड दैट आर यू स्पोक्सपर्सन फॉर इंडिया, सो यू नो देयर इज आल्सो समवेयर इन आवर लाइफ देयर इज दिस ट्रेडिशनल कांसेप्ट दैट एज जर्नलिस्ट व्हिच इज आवर जॉब टू बी क्वेश्चनिंग द अथॉरिटीज, सो यू नो शुड वी नॉट, आई मीन यू नो you are of course giving a perspective, Indian perspective to the international world. But when things are going wrong, should we not question or should we just purely showing the brighter side of things? I think this perception, as Preeti was saying, the perception battle or the perception as it has come to be defined, is that, you know, we media houses tend to show only one side of the story and not the entire story.
I want to start this answer by slightly disagreeing with what the co-panelists have been saying. When you say that you're a spokesperson, you're expressing your opinion, I don't do it to pander to your audience. I'm not going to say something just because I feel that today this is a sentiment, this is what people want to hear. I'm going to speak against a Jaish-e-Mohammed of Pakistan or Obama or that because I believe this. And if people agree with what we're saying, the brand of journalism that we stand for, I will not change my position today because the Congress government tomorrow is immediately government. And government's coming to office only because people vote for it. So that is a reflection of public sentiment. So tomorrow there's a Congress government, I will not change my position and say everything that is government is doing.
What initially you think bad is bad, irrespective of who is in power. Rishabh, I just want to take that to you. As I said, there are times when anchors or media houses need to be maybe spokesperson. For example, to call out Pakistan and say that you have got to stop exporting terror. You know, they're not too opinionated about it. You can't leave the audience with some question, you know, that for the sake of neutrality, that we take a neutral position. I mean, that's only somebody else can do that. But in our country, when we are facing a real threat,
to take you're right. What am I supposed to say? I'm supposed to get somebody from Pakistan and say, oh, they're saying they're militants. Let's discuss the fact that pensions are being used. That's not going to happen, right? And that's not going to happen, but it's absolutely right. All principles agree that you also got to believe in something. And in the end, you are responsible and accountable. There might be perceptions about channels, but there are also perceptions about us as individuals. We're sitting there, right? We're not remote controlling something. This is our face, what we are saying. We are controlling. Nobody's talking in my ear and telling me what to say and what to ask. Once the button is pressed, I'm there. All of us are there. And we are accountable to what we are saying. That accountability for ourselves keeps and should keep all of us in check. And I just felt this on that accountability and at my precinct. When you're questioning things that are happening in this country, if you're questioning price rises, if you're questioning fuel hikes, if you're questioning problems that are taking place, if you're questioning the response to a terror attack, these questionings are in the system. The political parties in the system will change. The nature of the job of questioning system cannot change. It must not change.
That's precisely what I was going to ask you. That, you know, there's always been a fine line between news and views. You know, in newspapers, for example, when we write a report, I write the report as it is, or as one saw. And views, of course, I can write whatever I want. But primarily, we see that, you know, you need to be pushed on the line, lost that, you know, anti-establishment attitude. That, I mean, I started my career with the Indian press, and it was a battle of honor at that point in time. Have we somehow lost it?
Yeah,
I've got to do what you guys always want. I'm completely running out of time. I'm just
listening to you. So, Preeti, I'll tell you, news and views, especially in TV media, go hand in hand. the minute a news breaks, you have to present the news around. So it's a 20-second anchor lead, and then we get the spokespersons to join us over the phone line, and then we immediately start giving out the news. So news and views are not that widely separated in TV broadcast, for sure. I mean, we can't bring out a feature, a 30-minute feature kind of a program every day, since it's only opinion. That doesn't happen. So when you are asking people to express your views immediately after the news break, we do end up taking a certain side sometimes, or end up relating to that side more quickly than the other. Then of course, then the news follow-up happens, and then you may end up changing sides. So it's not like, like I said earlier, we're not following any script here. It all depends on the go and how the story is.
Discussions will go on, and the viewers decide what they want to watch, and as